Welcome back to my garage. Last video, I was asking if someone could five-axis machine the new sleeve for me. And I've had some, and people reminded me, Staalesen Mekaniske Verksted was the, they machined this before I defiled it with my welding and machining. So thank you again, Staalesen Mekaniske, on a five-axis machine. But I've been thinking, and it's always been the goal here to have a fully fledged prototyping facility where I can do everything myself. That's been one of the goals here. And that means we probably should like come up with a system where machining sleeves and minimize handwork on sleeves, on porting, on the ports in the sleeves. Where did I start here? We've got to find a system where we can do that, because otherwise this is not a fully fledged prototyping facility we're after achieving here. So like the first thing, and people have suggested it, the first thing is like a dividing head, and you have those dividing heads with two axes, so the rotary axis and also a tilt axis. And there's actually a company not too far away which sells one, a small one, that's not too expensive. The problem, I think, is that it's, I think the problem will be that it is still too large for my mill. Like, the said height of my mill is so compromised. I'm actually gonna, let's take some measurements there and see. Because that would be like the most flexible solution, because then we're not like, I have been thinking about, we might still make something that has like an octagonal thing mounted on each side where we can switch out for 8 different positions, rotary positions, and then use some like angle blocks or stuff and to get the angles correctly, like the angles to reach. The absolute best thing would be to create like a cradle with the rotary axis, so that we could flip the whole thing like this and also rotate it. I've seen some posts on Instagram where people have made their own five-axis machines. So that would be, but that's a big project on its own. Let's take some measurements in the mill and check that dividing head. People have expressed concerns about like vibration marks in the cylinder, and yes, there's lots. This is a high-speed steel milling cutter, and I didn't have anything carbide long enough, otherwise we would have had much less shatter. How do you pronounce that, the vibration marks here? I'm gonna hone it a little bit before pressing, and also the roundness from using this, it's not perfectly round. Should have, like, a boring bar would be better, a boring head. I've actually got one, but the problem is the said height, so I can't really use that here. But I've taken measurements earlier with this mill, and it's surprisingly accurate. I've got the typical tool length we would use for machining a sleeve here, a 5mm ball nose cutter. So let's see how much clearance we have here. Let's bump this up against the soft limit, where the soft limit starts kicking in. In this position, it's not a problem. The C-port 55, that's unachievable with that dividing head. It would probably look something like this. Like, fixturing this with blocks and stuff would not be a problem. But, that dividing head would be such a nice addition to what I'm doing here. So this is the dividing head in question. Center height of 100 millimeters. So the center height would be there. Which means in this position, it'll work perfectly. Well, it doesn't tilt like there, it tilts higher up. We'll run out of height fast, which is a problem. One thing though, with how this mill is set up, I can reach the table easily with like it's there's far too much set travel in the other direction. I've got a soft limit set here, but you can see how with a tool in there, this could actually be raised like maybe 10 millimeters, not 10 centimeters, 100 millimeters. And that would give us a lot of more room to play with.
Hmm.
Let me think about it a little bit here. While thinking about which way to go, let's fix this. So this is my soon to become engine dyno, brake disc engine dyno. This is just a placeholder for a water brake that is actually in the making. People have commented that this should be parallel to this and or perpendicular to this. Well, actually it shouldn't, but it should be perpendicular to the axis of rotation. And it isn't, because I just mounted it. It's not far off, but it should be actually angled a little bit more in this direction, a little bit. I'll be in the way of the camera probably now, but that should be pretty much spot on. Like that. And now it should be perpendicular to the axis of rotation. To the axis of rotation. Yeah, looking good. Like that. I think I've settled on making two octagonal blocks pinching the cylinder or the sleeve from each side. And then we have eight positions, and with a adaptive clearing and a scallop cut, I think I can get most of the port shape by doing that. And then we'll create some kind of a angle block assembly so that we can get the rest of the ports roughly. We'll have to do some finishing because the radiuses in the port edges are really small and would require like a 1 millimeter cutter. Might be doable, but it needs some length to be able to reach, and we'll see. I was just gonna order some aluminium stock, and it seems like the place I've my go-to place for aluminium stock, their website does not state they're selling stuff anymore. And, I'm trying to call them, but they're not answering. So let's not hope they're out of business or something, because it's cyclestart.no, Norwegian company, because that would be a bummer, because it's pretty much the only place where you can buy cut to length pieces of aluminium stock nearby here, unless you want to buy like big pieces. Hmm. The pull stud pusher thing is still not adjusted properly, which means we'll have to do this fairly nerve-wracking operation. Crowbarring the tool out of there. Reminder, adjust that pull stud pusher thing. Almost wants to go under, which is great. A nice fit. Well, not a fit, but it will be when I press it in there. What she said. I'm a little bit concerned about my accuracy if I'm gonna use this as the is my means of making this accurate enough. I think we'll be fine. So this will be interesting, a 1.5 millimeter super long relative to the diameter end mill. It's carbide at least, so it's stiff, but that also means it's brittle, and it's not the most rigid machine this, so let's see what happens. This is just to minimize the amount of work I'll have to do here. So if this just breaks and fails, then we're still fine, but let's see. I'll halve the speed of like 500 millimeters per minute and see what happens. The feed rate from 500 millimeters per minute to 1,000 incrementally, which seems like, well, 500 seems to be fine. I broke it, I'm not sure if I got that on camera, but 700 might also be fine, but 1,000 was not fine, and And now I regret trying to make this faster, because I don't think I've got any more of those in on hand. We'll see. So that was stupid. So let's try that again, now with my best substitute for that 1.5 millimeter long carbide end mill. 2 millimeter, not as long, HSS end mill. It might look pretty much finished, but there's another operation, and that's to angle all the port roofs, because currently everything is, all the roofs are like straight 90 degrees from the bore, because three-axis mill. So now we'll have to redo all these operations, well, not all, not the whole operations, but redo everything, but with the cylinder sitting at the correct angle. And the correct angle is 25 degrees for the exhaust port and for the A transfers, and 10 for these ports, but I can have it sitting at 25 and get the roofs done like without setting it to a different angle than 25. The C port has to be sitting at 60 degrees to be able to reach the roof. So that's the only one that's the different, the only operation different to the others. I'm going to create zero pockets here, which like angled zero pockets, so that when it's sitting like this I can accurately zero the cylinder. Otherwise it's really difficult to zero on something sitting like this, because the height makes a difference from, like, there's no straight section to zero on, if you get what I mean. So that's our final operation with everything sitting like this. I'm gonna clamp this parallel down here like a stop, so that when this is butting up against this and here, I know it's sitting at 25 degrees. Well, as close to 25 as the accuracy of this can get us, but I think that'll be good enough. Let's see if this is repeatable. It's sitting at 25 degrees now. Looks repeatable. Let's try turning it. We got a problem. So this is butting up against here, and if only I'd made this completely round. I'm not sure why I. Well, I think I didn't have the enough material to make it round. So take two, now with some parallels clamped to the vise floor, and we'll have to make a minor adjustment here. Now when this is butting up against the parallels on the vise floor and up against this, it should be sitting at 25 degrees and be repeatable. Let's see. 25, okay. Let's call this good and start machining. Let's hope there's enough reach to be able to zero here. Just barely, but enough. I just realized that this washer not sitting perfectly centered is in some positions interfering with this, and unfortunately I think it interfered a little bit while doing that operation. Well, maybe not, but definitely it will do when I will do when I'm gonna do this operation, which is now. I'm gonna take 1 millimeter off this when it's pressed into the cylinder, so that's why I wasn't concerned about hitting this surface. I didn't record all those angled operations because it was just more of the same thing all over, except for the C-port, but pretty much the same, just angled more. So I'm actually in the middle of editing, and I just needed to make an outro and show the finished piece. So finish editing the video and get it out, and next episode, which will be in this week, probably Friday, will we'll finish this, like deburr, and looks good. So deburr it, get it pressed into here, and get the cylinder finished. And then we can reassemble and actually start testing again, and test that brake disc dyno. So see you next time. Thanks for watching.